Okay. Thank you, guys. So I'm really happy to be after Next. So Tim from Next, because this is part of what I'm going to talk about. So I'm here to talk about lightning fast server-side in React and the Valley of Lies. I'm from Crystallize, the bike thing. We're a headless PIM with a super fast GraphQL API, and we're really, really focused about one thing in particular, speed, our main passion. So much, in fact, that we forced our illustrator into making this. Well, we didn't force him. He loved it, but yeah. So we are fast, headless PIM. Our typical client is React ecommerce. So how do you make that fast? Well, you go to Next.js, right? You just apply server-side rendering, and you're done, right? Well, it turns out there's a big downside to SSR, and let's talk about that. So your typical user on a server-side React app types in your address, waits for a bit, because, well, everyone knows it starts at white. And hey, here we go. It's ready, our beautiful website. Is it ready, though? Web developers, we know. Yeah, it looks ready, right? It's server-side rendered. You got the HTML. You got the CSS. It's not really ready, is it, huh? We're waiting for something. We're waiting for React, rehydration, time to interactive, all of these kind of things. It's coming. Now it's ready. Can you tell the difference? Yeah, I could. I guess you all could, too. I bet the users, all the users know this. They'll just, you know, sit back and wait and relax. Yeah, time to interactive is about to hit. I'll just, you know, I'll wait. They won't. If you're running an e-commerce, this is what's going to happen. This, obviously, this is like rough terms. So you got your speed index metric. Wait a bit. Time to interactive hits. And in between this time frame, this is called the Uncanny Valley. It's a relatively unknown term. I wasn't even aware that it had a name until yesterday. So by the show of hands, who's heard of this and who knows what it is? Yeah, good. Like 5%, maybe. So I like the name, but it's kind of fuzzy. I have my own name for this. Looks interactive, eh? Or just this for short. Because effectively, this is what we're doing. We're giving the users a lie for a period of time before they can use the system. But for how long? Check out our own website. Crystallize.com on a typical dev setup, MacBook Pro. I'm on fiber. Obviously, it'll work. So I'm having excellent connection. I still have a 1.5 second of lies before I can use the system. What about Moto G4 on the bus on a regular 3G connection? For how long do you have to wait before you can even click like the menu button? 9 seconds. Imagining having the website and for 9 seconds you can't do anything really. You know, scrolling is laggy. You try to click the menu button, nothing happens, and you say, hey, screw the internet, it doesn't work. So you're getting 9 seconds of this. The main fact, I mean, the main reason, I bet you all know, it's, well, we're booting out React, rehydrating the stores, and we're doing all that cool stuff. We could just, you know, say it's JavaScript, in fact. Not all. There's a bit more to it. But in essence, that's the, you know, this is what happens. And something has happened over the past years. It didn't used to be like this in the past. But we tend to have created a monster. And you can get away with code splitting. And there's a lot of cool techniques you can do. But so Netflix, back in 2017, addressed this and even implemented this on their front page. So they tried to just server-side render React on the server and on the client side, do it vanilla. You know, and they had, you know, massive effects on that. So for now, let's just end with an experiment. Crystallize is a part of a group called the New Normal Group, and they have a really nice, simple website. It's server-side rendered React, because it's using Crystallize as a backend, so it needs to be dynamic. And the only thing happening on the client side is this menu thing opening up. I think we can do that in vanilla.js. So let's see the differences. So the full-fledged Next.js version, where we boot up everything from scratch on the client side, React, and do all of that stuff, you're lying for 6.6 seconds. If you just remove all JavaScript, right, the user is only getting HTML and CSS, we're going to see how much of our lie is JavaScript. And we did a test, same setup. I have to mention again, this is, again, with this cell phone, right? Moto G4, 3G connection, lying for 6.6 seconds. Without JavaScript, it's only a 2.5 second lie. Not too bad. So I just want to make sure that when you do server-side render React applications, have this in mind. The uncanny valley, or the big lie, whatever you call it, make sure that you are addressing this. I know it's, you know, some excellent work is being done. There are some wonderful blog posts from Ari Osmani, Jason Miller, about this kind of thing. But in essence, you need to take responsibility of this and convince your management that you need time, right? Because they don't really know. And you can go to them and say, hey, we need to fix the uncanny valley. Yeah, well, good luck. You could try to give it a better name, like this. Yeah. Or something else that you might prefer. Management loves something that has, like, you know, I don't know, power, turbo, and all that. Yeah, this is something they want. OK, that's my talk. Thank you.